If there are any YouTubers out there who are going to make a video response to this, well, actually, Cap G, the format is super fun. Just open with 10 hand traps every game and don't get needle fiber cut. Just stop. Because I feel like even if you're going to make that video, before you do, I'll just preemptively ask you, when was the last time that you, as a YugiTuber, spent hours playing this game and you were not compensated? I'm talking about you just played for the love of the game, not because you're getting paid by your live stream, not because you're getting paid by pro play games or anything like that. I feel like if you really ask yourself that question and you're being honest, you're probably not even going to remember the answer, or you're just going to come up with an answer that's not 2020.
Okay, that's easy. So the last time I had fun playing Yu-Gi-Oh! As a YugiTuber was 2000. Damn it! What is up, guys? Go here, and welcome to today's video. This is going to be a little bit different since I don't usually make response videos, but this topic actually piqued my interest. So what we're going to respond to is CapG's video that Yu-Gi-Oh's dead in 2020. Let's get on to this.
But let's start talking about the reasons. Reason number one, there are no tournaments. And you guys know exactly why that is. Because of the coronavirus, Konami initially started out by canceling regionals, and then they moved to the YCS, and then Worlds and National Season, and basically everything was taken off the table. And by the way, I'm not blaming Konami in any way for us not having events, because obviously that is because of the pandemic, but it still is affecting just, you know, my overall enjoyment of Yu-Gi-Oh! In 2020.
So yeah, when it comes to the corona situation in the US at least, well, I don't have much to say about it, I don't want to get too political, but I don't think that the US, at least the citizens in the US, are handling this pandemic accordingly. I can understand this point, mostly due to the fact that I wanted to go to my nationals this year, and also the European Double CQ, which was held a 2-hour train ride from my place. Alas, bats had a different plan in mind.
The second reason, the meta game is absolute trash. Oh my goodness. The meta is just so unbelievably bad right now. And, you know, Konami had the opportunity to address some of these issues on our recent ban list. Of course, they didn't do anything that really impacted the meta in a significant way. So I understand that they can, you know, say, well, there are no events, so what do you expect us to do? We're not going to ban out all these archetypes that you guys haven't even been able to play at regionals or YCSs.
Well, the metagame was always what it was, a metagame. So whenever something more powerful came out, it just overtook the decks that were already in the meta. It hadn't changed, and it will not change in the future. However, due to the power creep spiraling out of control, this is not a good thing. I assume we all know that the recent ban list didn't address any of the recent meta decks. I can understand Konami's reasoning though. There were no actual live events, so there was nothing to base that ban list on. And if they were to address Eldritch or Adamancipator, they would also have to address the online scene, that being Dueling Book, Edo Pro, etc. And that's not something they will do.
Reason number three as to why Yu-Gi-Oh! Is dead in 2020, at least to me, and this is probably the saddest of the three reasons, the meta game is going to get worse. At least that's my prediction. And usually, you could have a positive outlook about a bad meta game by thinking, well, don't worry, Cap G, on the next ban list, Konami will fix the problems and then the meta game will be good again. But I don't think that we can have that because we know exactly what's coming down the pipe. We know that we're getting Don Thousand's Numeron cards, and those cards are just absolutely ridiculous. I mean, I'm talking should have never been printed, broken in the anime, broken in real life, dominating the OCG like tier zero status. It's not just the Numeron cards coming out. We got Red Eyes Dark Dragoon, another cancer card that completely warped the entire OCG format. We're getting that in our Megatons, and it's just like, bruh, the game and the meta are already so ridiculously bad. How could it possibly get worse? Okay, we'll just give you guys even more broken, unfun crap, and then we'll call it a day. So
I've already mentioned the metagame spiraling out of control, and what CapG is saying here pretty much confirms it. Everything that comes down the line will be stronger than what came before it. We're in a never-ending spiral of power creep. Also, when it comes to Dragoon, the next ban list is set up to be in September, and Dragoon comes out in August, if I remember correctly. So we'll have a month, or maybe month and a half of Triple Dragoon in the meta. This isn't very fun. Besides that, when it comes to the Numeron cards, they are very powerful, yes, but the OCG is not dominated by them. I don't know where CapG took the statement from. It just might have been his biased opinion. According to Road of the Kings, the current metagame in the OCG is not dominated by the Numeron cards. It's actually dominated by Orcust and Sky Striker.
I do think that Phantom Rage having 17 TCG exclusives, that's incredibly interesting. I've been talking about this before. If Konami were to break that down into three completely brand new TCG exclusive archetypes, that could be really interesting. Even if they're not meta, that could end up being really exciting, and I would definitely like that.
Well, when it comes to TCG exclusive archetypes, it has its ups and downs. Should those 17 cards in Phantom Rage be divided between three TCG exclusive archetypes, I assume that we'll get something like a new Cosmo, which was meta pretty much on release, and two archetypes which are equivalent to FA. Okay, so now it's time for my personal opinion on the matter, not responding to CapG anymore. Or maybe it'll still be considered a response. I don't know, and quite frankly, I do not care. Yu-Gi-Oh! Was dying many times. People proclaimed Yu-Gi-Oh! As dead when Synchro Monsters came out. The same happened when the Xyz mechanic was introduced, Pendulums, and Lynx. Every time the game prevailed. Yu-Gi-Oh! As a game will never die unless Konami lets it die. Unless Konami stops supporting it, stops making cards, then the game will be dead. What is happening right now is people getting to their breaking point. The game will not die as a business. It will not die as a card game, but it will die for people because everyone has a breaking point. For some, it was the introduction of Synchro Monsters. For others, it was Xyz, Pendulums, or Lynx. And for some, is a one-card needle fiber combo with five negations at the end of it. We just came to the point where people who were stuck with this game for years, some even for more than a decade, just are at their breaking point. And I think CapG and many others who agree with him just passed that point. Either now or much earlier. But the game, as a game, will never die. And that will be it for today. Thank you everyone for watching, and should you want anything to be added, please do it down below in the comments. Also, please remember to be respectful. Thank you, and goodbye.